Well, howdy everybody, Jughead here, and of course we're all kind of staying at home, still flying for the airlines, but after that trying to stay away from everybody. So I'm just down at the hangar right now, and you know, I was making some logbook entries here and going through some of my old entries, and I came across one that reminded me about a neat flight, and I went back, looked on my computer, and I still had some of the video from it. So I thought I'd share this story with you. And this was back in the early 90s. I had the opportunity to fly down to McAllen, Texas with a young man who was trying to get his commercial instrument rating so he could fly for the Washington State Patrol. Amazing story. The guy's name was John Montemayor. Actually grew up as a migrant farm worker hoeing the beets in my family's farm fields. And he went on to be the highest time Washington State Patrol pilot ever. He retired just a few years ago. I still talk to him every couple months, and it was fun to catch up. But on this entry, we had just gone south of Del Rio, Texas. First time I'd ever been down there. Little would I know that I would spend almost 6 years there later. But we came across, the logbook entry talks about, came across a ghost town. Found out it was the Lonesome Dove film site, sitting on the banks of the Rio Grande River. Saw deer, turkeys, and pigs along the way. And what a cool story, because Lonesome Dove actually was a TV show that I really enjoyed watching later. And so if we come up here to my map, we can actually see the trip here started up in Moses Lake, Washington. We were flying a Cessna 172, and it was going to be a quick trip down to McAllen, Texas. He needed some hood time, so I was a safety pilot. We went down to Bend, Oregon, Redmond area, down into Redding, California, and then all the way down Sacramento where the first night. We came on down to Palmdale, over to the Phoenix area, Falcon Field there. Went into El Paso, saw some of the NASA assets there, and then down to Del Rio. This was the area about 8 miles south of Del Rio where it was found, and then into McAllen. But it was a really neat deal, and now I hope I'll share the video with you that I have shot since then, because later in my Air Force career, my last duty assignment was Del Rio. That's where I picked up 97 Bravo here. And I wasn't as good with her and didn't have the skills and confidence that I do now. So as you see in this video, there's a lot of places that I could have safely landed today, and I would do it again. But at the time, it just wasn't worth it for me to make those landings. But I caught some cool overhead video footage showing, comparing what the movie set looked like in the early 90s compared to what it looked like in 2006-2007 timeframe. Actually, no, that would have been like 2010 to 2012 time frame. All right, I must be getting old. I'm starting to confuse all my dates. Hey, big shout out. Check out this cool sweatshirt. I just ordered up some nice parts from Airframes Alaska. And as a surprise in the box, here was this great sweatshirt. Oh, it is so warm and comfy. Kind of perfect right now, because out here in Snohomish, we've got the springtime weather. We get sunshine and then we get hail and rain. Eastern Washington right now has picked up 1.5 inches of snow. The mountains are getting 6 to 12 inches. Oh, it's killing me. Unfortunately, everything is closed down. We can't go play. But so hopefully you'll enjoy this little trip back in my logbook and see a neat asset. And hey, while you're killing time, go download the Lonesome Dove series and watch all the great movies and TV that was filmed at this location.